The events of that day were to lead to one of the most bizarre crimes in the annals of American history. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The film which you are about to see is an account of the tragedy which befell a group of five youths. It is all the more tragic in that they were young. But had they lived very, very long lives, they could not have expected, nor would they have wished to see, as much of the mad and macabre as they were to see that day. For them, an idyllic summer afternoon became a nightmare. For 30 years, the files collected dust in the cold cases division of the Travis County Police Department. Over 1,300 pieces of evidence were collected from the crime scene at the Hewitt residence. Yet none of the evidence was more compelling than the classified police footage of the crime scene walkthrough.
Test, test, test. Okay, this is August 20th, 1973. The time is 3:47 p.m. The location is the Hewitt residence on Route 17. It's where victim one was found. We're going to do a walkthrough, and we're now descending the stairs into the furnace room. There's, over here, there's scratch marks along the wall. There's some more over here. Along here, and, oh, there's something over here. Seems to be...
It's like a pot of hair and an embedded fingernail. Into
the actual furnace room.
Watch yourself.
Oh, man. Got it? Alright. This is the actual furnace room. Going into.
Where are they? Suspected to be perpetrated.
Got a bit of a jump there. Come on back here. Follow me. Come on.
The crime scene was not properly secured by Travis County Police. Two investigating officers were fatally wounded that day. This is the only known image of Thomas Hewitt, the man they call Leatherface. The case today still remains open.